everybody, welcome back to Riesenbeck. It is autumn. Finally, we are into autumn. And we are doing our first harvest. And since we've got plenty of money in the bank, thought we'd make ourselves a little bit of an upgrade. Hey, Anthony, Mouse, and no such person. What's up, everybody? We're going to do ourselves a little bit of an upgrade. So, and that's what we're going to get. Hey, Clint, what's up? All right, so we got ourselves a new truck. And if you saw my mod review on this earlier today, you kind of know the ins and outs of what this thing can already do. But I thought it fit the map. It's the right price. And I thought it was pretty darn cool. You like how it's got an animated stick shift clutch? Guess somebody imported a Russian truck down into Florida. We made about $89,000 off of our hay that we sold the other day, so I thought I would treat myself to this truck. That also means is we can get rid of this other trailer. We don't need it anymore. It should make selling our crop a little quicker too. Comes time to close out the map. Hey, AK in the hay. Hey, right before I went live, I got something all up in my throat, trying to get all that cleared out. I think we might be good now, getting close to it. I don't think we'll get too much for the trailer here. Yeah, not too terrible much. But we could offset that with where is it? We could offset that with this one. Double our hauling capacity. Trailer must be heavy. This tractor didn't want to take off. Sounds like, Anthony, that there is a tip collision preventing the drop of the windrow there. Just an old, rough-looking truck. Hey Frank, what's up? We also have our barley ready to harvest, but we got rain in the forecast for this afternoon, and I figure we probably wouldn't be able to get the barley off the field with the straw baled up, get it off the field before it would go and rain on us. Come on. Sometimes you ever feel like the fence just is magnetic, jumps out and gets you. If all goes well, we'll hopefully be able to close this map out sometime this week. Plan is to get into winter, sell off the cows and the pigs, sell off the crops when the prices are good. And then we are going to be moving over to another project or our live streams. In fact, it's going to be a multiplayer server. Oh my gosh, I can't get my throat clear. We'll be starting that project actually tomorrow night. Going to be a multi-farm economy type server on the Candolin map. All right, let's empty this. Yep, I've already got the map from his update last week. This is the truck that was in the video this week. Yeah, today. Really nice animations on the suspension. Look close, you can see the suspension moving there. The animations on the drive shafts, you can really see on the semi version. I took the engine cover off, put the skid plate on, painted it up. I'm in the wrong vehicle. Hey, David, what's up? I did, Frank, earlier today. I thought, you know what, that truck would work just fine on this map. We've got a harvest coming up, so and I had the money. We had about $190,000 because those keeping score, we had $82,000 in biogas income, where we sold all of that hay from the last stream. Didn't have a chance to fast forward. Oh, you've got... So Father's Day in Australia is in August. Well, I guess September. You're September 1st at this point. So we have our Father's Day in June. So we'll be running on the Candolin map. We're going to be playing the sheep farm. We're going to be sheep farmers and arable farming. playing this map and you need a quick cash, sell hay down to the pig BGA if you own that. They pay quite royally for hay. For some reason, they like hay a lot more than they like silage. Did anyone catch the weekend roundup video from this morning? Curious if anyone else had the issues I had with the John Deere seeder. I was able to hook it up and in a 3-seeder configuration, but I couldn't get the 2 back seeders to actually work. Curious if anyone else do the trick on that. Then the sheep husbandry area, it acted awful strange when I put it down. Cedar worked fine in a single configuration. It showed where you could hook up 2 on the sides, they would trail the first, but I couldn't get the trailing ones to actually function. Yeah, how full this is. Oh, I think we got plenty of room. Get the rest of this field. I mean, it seems to work well. It's very nicely priced for its working width. In the single configuration, and it's a shame that I mean, hopefully it works tripled up. Maybe I was just doing something wrong. Because it would be a really, really cheap 18 meter wide seeder configuration. Yeah, I wish you could change the color of the back on the seed tender. You know, it's red permanently. No, I didn't try the helper. See, we can't... Can't change the, back. Be nice if we could. Yeah, the auger has, you know, up and down, and a whole lot of motion on that. That's a little target dot on the ground. That was a nice little thing. It's a little awkward to be able to fill the second container with a different product. But it does work. I demonstrated that in the video. Basically have to hit pipe out to the other side. And then once the other side is selected, you can then pick a different fill type fill from. I wouldn't think the helper would have a clue what to do with that triple seater setup. He definitely wouldn't be able to back it up. It's not a setup that you you reverse once you have it hooked up. Got this door open, but I don't remember how to shut it. It's okay. Even have indicator lights on the dash. Anthony, I have not played on Hagenstad. And we've got kind of like a, the duels, we've got kind of a, what is that, like a combined air fill valve or something? I didn't think we would have time to get this barley up off the field, but you know what? That seems to be about all we have to go on at this point. Might as well get started on it and see if we can't get it done. I mean, technically, this map doesn't have a snow mask or a seasons mask, so we don't have to worry about straw rotting in the ground. But, you know, we'll pretend that it would have an effect. And off we go. Yeah, there isn't like a script, right? Where your power poles could have nodes on them or something. And then you could run a script that would string the lines. Speaking of your guy wires, I've run into a few of those on Emerald Coast. Made me think about, sometimes they put that colored plastic tape and tie it around the guy lines a little bit. Do you see this tape floating in the air, flapping in the wind? Like, there's something there. No, that would probably be true pain in the tail to try to implement. pretty darn good yield off this. We're already 84% full. Ground just one time. Yeah, the plastic sheathing. Hey, Super Ford, what's up? Vehicle again. Well, I guess, I mean, we're probably going to be okay. These barley fields are small. Didn't have any problem getting them up now, I think. There, that's what closes the door. We've got a pole down the street from us that has a rubber snake tied to it, hanging about 5 feet up off the ground. Took me a while to figure out what on earth that thing was. Well, David, depending on the map you're playing, 100,000 might not last very long. Might be just That could be just one field. Anthony, that's an impossible question to answer. No one knows what mods are going to be coming out next month, other than some subset of the mods that are in the testing thread on Giants Forum. We assume they're going to be coming out within the next month. It's another 200 and some mods waiting to be tested over at Giants Forums. They have a 4-week waiting period on those at this point. So that would fall within the next month. So if you hire a worker, worker can make all three work, but he's not going to be able to turn around, right? Usually workers back up and try to do all these, you know, reversing maneuvers. Yeah, Emerald Coast, you could probably get, depending on what field you own, you could probably do a field or two. Hey Darren, what's up? Glad to have you here. Glad you're enjoying the content. Hey, GTX. What's up? I was going to hire a helper and then go dump this, but I'll go dump this now and then I know the other Darren is looking forward to the mod that Duck Zorley put a video out on. A mirror. Yeah, I got a rear window. Cool. Hey, IB Hauling, what's up? Yeah, that one, of course, it's probably somewhere like 2 or 3 weeks out from being tested. To harvest. Yeah, sometimes I wonder if they're maybe a little bit too focused on this Farm Sim League stuff. Alright, Anthony, catch you later. We'll be streaming tomorrow night. We'll be over on the new map, Candolin. Getting that one started. Yeah, that's what I figured also. With respect to the Platinum. I know if the Platinum is going to be released on time, they basically need to have it in Microsoft's and Sony's hands sometime in early, mid-September. So, you know, you've got that. Got... I suspect some folks had left for holiday vacation, whatever you want to call it, after the mod contest. Because everything just seemed like it just came to a really, really slow slowdown after the mod contest. Of course, if the dev control mod's been with Giants since the 7th of August, tomorrow will be the 1st of September for us. That's nearly a month right there. That's if it comes out this week. lost a little patch of barley there due to, I guess, dry conditions. Well, Fleming Boot, that was an assumption, I think, that lots of folks made, because there's been a new map with the Platinum Edition of 17, 15, and maybe even 13. But there was never mentioned by Giants that there was such a new map. It sounds like the Platinum expansion is just a class add-on, if you will. I agree with you, Will. Equipment can stand the test of time. Maps, we'll get so fickle with maps. It'd be interesting to see what the average number of hours a typical farm sim player puts in on any one given map. I would say console players probably put the most time on any one given map, simply because there are less maps available, so they spend more time playing on any one given map that is available. But for PC players, when there are literally hundreds of possibilities out there, with new maps dropping literally daily, seems to be that there's a large contingent of players that map hop, dare I say, about as fast as they change their undergarments. I don't have a video on the new interface with guidance steering. That sounds pretty bad there. I mean, with seasons 100 hours in, have you really been able to get very far? Come back, Anthony. It's That's not a good long-term strategy, though, to anger the lady. So did you see from Amigo Boot that Alien Jim is working on a 19 Sussex? Hey, Blue Jeans, what's up? He just made a post today. Didn't read it all, so I'm not sure. That's where he said he was halfway, or... Uh-oh. That's what they say, right? When the house gets too quiet, there's better go walk around and see what's going on. We are getting really good yield off of these fields. Hey, Fredman, what's up? Not much. We're just trying to get some barley off the field. Then we need to get the straw up off the field. We got rain coming. Rain around 3 o'clock. Boss will be part of the Platinum Expansion. It will be the Platinum Expansion in October. Our two cornfields here we need to harvest once they're ready, and of course we have the We planted corn over there also by the pigs because we're going to put that in the silage bunker. Might be four, I can tell you, I have no idea. I thought it was a menu option. When I see Mr. Sealy T do it, it seems like he always has to go to the menus. Say show help screen. Talking about that menu right there. Now all we have is corn, and corn. Let's go put this away. All right, catch you later, David. Yeah, I would think turning would be pretty bad with five. That would be that probably was fun hooking up too. Right? Hide this over here for now. Terry, because I don't merge fields. It's just something I don't do. Maybe one day I would want to have different crop in those fields. Hey Anthony, what's up? Multiple Anthonys. Gotta remember which one's been here, which one's not. Missed our entrance. There we go. Hey Tom, what's up? To see how many bales we get of straw off of here. Let's reset our counter again. We'll have to add one to our counter. Well, tonight, we don't have anything else to harvest tonight. We're going to be baling straw and collecting it off the field. We've got 3 fields of corn left. Two over here on this side of the map. We're going to harvest for grain. We've got a field of corn over by the pigs. I want to forage and put that in a silage bunker. Oh, no problem, Flaming Flamingo. Or Flamingo Boot. Now, I haven't been putting out as many. Mostly because I've been kind of looking to cherry pick, you know, the good ones, things that stand out. You know, there's edits of edits of edits out there, and it's like, well, how are they any really different? Tom, of course there's glitches. There's glitches with just about everything. I would say nothing that's game-breaking. Well, I won't take full credit. There's lots of folks out there that suggest things. What were some of the glitches in 17 seasons? Uh-oh. Let's see, which one was that? No, that was not it. There we go. I'm not following you, Anthony. I thought you were asking about glitches with seasons. I think you say something like that there was a lot of them in what I assumed was Farm Sim 17. And then you say all maps, so then I'm really confused. Well, you were saying that there were a lot of glitches in seasons for 17. There are 11 bales off of this field. The auto stop and unload around balers is a godsend. Mouse, I haven't tried those sawmill mods. I downloaded the one that had a couple different sawmills. The ones that were huge. Oops, sorry about that. The ones that were huge. I don't know why, but I stopped looking at them and I deleted them. That was a couple weeks ago. I don't remember why. Then I think there was another sawmill mod that was out there that was like 120-some megs for a building. And I was like, why is this mod so big? I didn't download that one just because it was a heck of a lot bigger than it should be. I thought it was. Still not following what you're saying, Anthony. When you there's Seasons has glitches when you drive. What has glitches when you drive? What are the glitches? I did see New Witchshire was listed in the testing thread for an update. Wonder if it's getting updated with a Seasons mask. Getting a lot of bales off of this field. Well, I don't know what the update is. I just know that I saw New Witchshire listed there. You don't have to update it. The glitches with silage. I'd be more apt to say that it was a glitch with the map. There's always going to be map glitches with Seasons unless the map author explicitly builds the map for the purpose of playing with Seasons and has done extensive testing with Seasons in the map. Is that the mixer? Is that the sawmill that takes up so much space? I mean, it was like the Farm Sim 17 sawmill. I'd seen some folks. Folks, I think, reported that with that mod, if they took it out of their mod folder, the map wouldn't load up anymore, the save game wouldn't work. Well, that's the interesting thing. Lone Oak wasn't in the... I thought Lone Oak was sent to Giants for testing, but we haven't seen it in any of the testing updates. Hey, Josh, what's up? So that was 25 bales of straw. And about 4 road signs. Oh, the day's not been terrible bad. Not over for me, though. I agree, Josh. Sim 17 is one of those games where you can just mellow out and just zone out and just do your thing. Get the world. Y'all remember we left this because I wanted this baler to be empty? I thought there'd be more there than that, but okay. So here's the field that we're going to forage at some point. Hey, Model Isher, what's up? Good early morning to you. What is it, like 4? Good guess. Good guess on the 6 hours ahead. Quarter of a day. Anybody have luck using that round bale trailer that came out this week? That was another fail in the weekend roundup. Try to stack that and see how many bales I could get on there, and it just fell apart. I don't know, Anthony. I don't think it's hit 40 yet. We were looking at it earlier. Because now the projected path is it's going to come close to making landfall at Florida, but it's going to curve up and make its way up the Georgia coast, South Carolina coast, and North Carolina coast. Probably make landfall around North Carolina. That'd be my guess. Looks like we might get rain. I might get rain from it next weekend. About the time it might hit North Carolina, it's going to be Cat 2, what they're projecting. Of course, that is all way preliminary. Things with hurricanes, they can change from hour to hour. I know there were lots of folks doing storm prep in Florida. It's always good to be prepared. Where I live, we'll just get a ton of rain. Not a ton. We'll get a half ton of rain. Yeah, like we were talking earlier this week, Will, it seems like storms that come up that angle, storms that make that East Coast approach to Florida seem to, they always seem to do that right hook. Occasionally you get the one that is bound and determined to make landfall and just comes barreling in. Seems like historically they come up like they're going to barrel straight into Florida and then they just make a right turn. Head to Albuquerque, so to speak. Hey, Rabbit Sean, what's up? Better put something on the front here. Oops. Make the magic forks materialize into something. Is it now? You'll need to let Giants know if it's not legit. Or has it been pulled from the mod hub? Hey Cam, what's up? Wipers are blinking, we must get rain. We're talking about this one. I don't know who did this one. Well, I guess maybe it's these folks. Where is it? No, visitlizard.de. That's not going to be the site. Hey, Morpheus, what's up? Thank you. Hey, how's that challenge map thing going? A trailer released this week from them. In the mod hub as of Friday. Kind of looked like this, but quite frankly, that one had problems as far as I was concerned. Check. I mean, it just got released. Oh, seriously? There it is going, isn't it? Wow. Jake Bale. Well, somebody asked where that Bale trailer went, and I don't know. Bales have I loaded on this trailer and not had a single issue. Tobacco, huh? Yeah, it's supposed to rain any minute now, I guess. Better than what? Better than base gameplay, as far as I'm concerned, they are. It's a bit more involved, so... it's not like just adding production to a map, to a game. It changes pretty much everything, so... I think the folks that have the hardest time are those that just aren't willing to forget or aren't willing to ignore how they think the game should play because seasons changes so much of it. We're gonna take this load down to the pigs. Pretty sad load of straw, but that's okay. I mean, we talked about the game being relaxing earlier, and for me, the base game isn't relaxing. The base game is monotonous, tedious, and you always feel like you're behind because you're always kind of racing the clock. I gotta get this done before the next growth stage. I gotta get this done before my crop wilts. I gotta get this done before that. Seasons paces you out. It's clearly a time to do field prep. Clearly a time to seed. It's clearly a time to harvest. Once you're done seeding, you're done. You don't have to worry about seeding for quite a long time again. So it kind of brings order to the mayhem, if you will. Straw. Yep, see? Doesn't want straw. Hay's a good fortune for hay, though. Oh. No. You can play, you know, you can play 3-day seasons, which is 12 game days is an entire year. I mean, there's lots of folks that probably haven't played 12 consecutive days on a map in base game. They probably think I have to spend 12 days in order before I can do any harvesting, for example. More like 90s, but you gotta change your gameplay a little bit. You're not in a scenario where you can harvest every day. It gives you time to do things like this. Stack bales to where you're not, like I said, fretting about needing to get other things done because, well, at some point the crop's going to grow. Well, you know the crop's not going to grow for another few days. Animals need fed every day now. Every other day. Right, you know, it doesn't matter if it takes me 3 hours to, other than the fact that you guys wouldn't want to watch. It takes 3 hours to load up bales. Forks are doing here. Makes pretty good money on Emerald Coast with contracts. That's for sure. while we're down here. And blow straw in here. Let's see where we are with our critters. They need water and food. Water. Killing food. Andy, we left the water trailer down here. Enough to hold them for now. This thing has a hitch on it. Let's see if I can get this trailer hooked up to this other trailer. Like a pro. Like a pro. Hey, Rockhound, what's up, bud? I think Forbidden Mods does a fairly good job at trying to provide a direct link to where a map author submitted, put their files. They seem to be a mod aggregator, but for a mod aggregator, they seem to do a pretty good job of linking back to a correct upload. Rockhound, we are doing multiplayer tomorrow night. Do you got that multiplayer itch? Yeah, we're going to start a new map tomorrow night. 4X map. I'm going to run the sheep farm, do some arable. I'll be streaming it my normal time. Let me add you to the group. Well, you'll see the server. Yep, alright, I added you to the group, so you'll see the server over in Discord. It's at the bottom of the list. It's called Candolin. So I was going to reset the server. It's running right now, kind of in play mode. I'm going to reset the server sometime tomorrow afternoon. And then... let's just jump the tractor. And I'd probably come in, I'll probably be on around 7 or something to start working on the server. I have lots of fields to bop up. We'll have lots of field work to do. Equipment to buy, things like that. It's because we didn't lock it down. We just restricted it so that it wasn't visible to everybody. There, I gave you permission to. Now, why would curious on your views of forbidden mods? Since it's a, since we're kind of doing a multi-farm economy type thing, yeah, you kind of got to be a, if you're not one of the farms, then it doesn't make much sense of being on. Like with them using stuff without permission, taking credit, stuff like that. Like it's raining, but is it really? We don't have the red crop icon. The wipers are running. Yeah, I would say that is a practice that sadly extends lots of areas. All right, catch you later there, Anthony. One, two, three, four, five. Let's see how many we can get on this trailer. The amount of time we're going to be playing left on the map. We have more straw bales than we need at this point. One, two, three, four. Yep. Look, I was worried we wouldn't get all this on before the rain came. I did hear, Rockhound, that actually I think it was Monolisha that posted it over on SimStation's Discord that they were they basically didn't require those EPN numbers or whatever anymore. Rockhound was really frustrated. With his silage bunker mod. That was up there. Because, you know, the way, unless you're used to doing, I guess, a lot of international banking, the average American doesn't have a clue about the stuff they were asking for. You know, you go to your bank, and you're like, well, they say I need this, this, and this. Your bank says, okay, we'll put this in. And then you go put that in. And then Giants is like, that's not a valid number. That's not in the right format. And you're like, well, I don't know. I mean, that's what the bank gave me. Right? Good. I don't know if it's worth the frustration, the months of frustration, but it's good that hopefully that finally does actually clear the bank. Yeah, you can't deny that that doesn't give you a little bit of motivation. Right? Yeah, 4 weeks is a bit on the crazy side. See, that's fairly good motivation then, right? All right, let's see what we're going to get per straw bale. Probably won't be much. Now's not the best time to be selling straw. $154 a bale. I'll bring it up. I'll bring it up here because I don't know why people think this. See, the barn has no price for hay, straw, or grass. None at all. It's dropping at zero. Tag the barn. See, that's the barn. For some reason, people think this means that you can't sell hay, straw, or grass. What that simply means is you can't sell it in bulk. You can't sell it loose. You have to bale it. And, I mean, it's interesting seeing some logic, folks' logic. And some folks have also thought that the price per bale was whatever the price was in the prices screen times four because of the fact that, a bale is 4,000 liters. And the prices in the prices screen are per 1,000 liters, but that's not the case either. Bale prices are fixed. In base game, they never change. In seasons, they change per day. But whatever the price of the bale is today, that's the price of the bale. So we managed to get all of that done. And just like Raz would say, the impeccable timing, we are now at our 2 hour mark. We're now at 2 hours, so we're going to go ahead and end the stream and just finish harvesting 3 fields, baling 2 fields, loading, and selling stuff. So we'll be back tomorrow night on a new server, starting up the multiplayer Candolin map. We'll be doing 12-day seasons. Server's going to run 24/7. And I'm going to run the sheep farm and do a little bit of variable. So check that out tomorrow night. Hey, Doughboy, what's up? Come in as we are leaving, man. Stuck. Yeah. Hey, can you chat? Jump in a voice channel, Doughboy, if you can. Catch you guys tomorrow. Happy farming.